Hey guys, Drifter here. Welcome to another double whammy episode of World War II In Depth. In today's episode, we're going to be reviewing the M1911 and machine pistols, respectively. And unlike the P08 9mm SAP, these two are about as far apart as they could possibly get performance-wise, and we're going to have a little bit of fun with them. Let's jump right in with the M1911 first, the classic weapon, one of the most classic weapons of all time, and one that I've fired quite a bit myself, so I'll talk about personal experiences later on, but let's talk about the damage. It'll deal a colossal 50 damage up close. At its medium range, it'll be 40 damage, and at its absolute maximum range, it'll be 30, which is 2, 3, or 4 shots to kill, depending on how far away you are from the enemy, and this is super high damage. This means that you can actually 2-shot and kill enemies, and that is very, very powerful. Headshot damage is 1.1x, which means that headshots are kind of useless, and on a 2-shot kill weapon, headshots aren't particularly useful to begin with, so I wouldn't worry about it. The 2-shot kill range is 9 meters, which I'm going to give a shocking rating. That's a really long range for a 2-shot kill weapon, and it surprises people all the time. It's just a little bit less than the maximum range of most shotguns, which makes the M1911 a surprising competitor to shotguns, especially when you're running it akimbo. However, this gun gets really bad outside of that 2-shot range. It does have an impressive 3-shot kill range, but it's statistically dominated by the P08 9mm SAP inside that range, and it gets kind of dumpy because of the rate of fire, which is 340 rounds per minute, and I'm going to give this a rating of uncomfortably slow. The average person can pull their trigger finger at about 500 to 600 rounds per minute with very little effort, so this is just barely more than half of that. So what you're going to run into is the oversampling problem. You're going to pull that trigger and spam it super fast as hard as you can, and the bullets just aren't going to come out when you pull the trigger, so it's going to feel like the gun is broken, like it's jamming, like it's not shooting fast. And the way you have to do this gun is slow down just a little bit and treat it like a more of a DMR in order to get that optimal rate of fire, or just work on your practice and timing. It's definitely not a spam weapon, and it can be very awkward handling at times. Time to kill, at least theoretical time to kill, is amazing as long as you hit 2 shots in a row. If you're up close and you hit your 2 shots and you kill somebody with that 2-shot kill, they die very, very quickly. It competes with shotguns, it outclasses the submachine guns, it's better than the bar, you are just straight dropping people. But once you start missing shots, that time to kill starts jumping because of the slow rate of fire, and akimbo can insta-kill people. There is no penalty for running akimbo to your damage, so you can get up close, pull both triggers, and somebody will die instantly. However, the fire cap rate bug was patched, so now it goes back to the normal rate of fire, and you can't super spam people at like 1200 rounds per minute. I put a sad face there because I kind of missed it. I had fun with it, but ultimately it was not well balanced. It wasn't something that really should have been in the game, so it was probably a good thing that it got patched. However, with akimbo, you can alternate your rates of fire if you want to and pick it back up to about 600 rounds per minute, which is very, very nice, and that's a lot of death coming out of the end of your barrels. Both normal and hipfire recoils are much higher than other pistols, and by this I mean the recoil you get when you aim down sights is quite high, and the recoil of your hipfire box, how it tends to kick upward and drag upwards if you're going akimbo, both of those are significantly higher than the other pistols and makes the M1911 much harder to use. When you are aiming down sights, I think the iron sights are actually great for lining up your first shot. Now, after you shoot your first shot, the barrel of the gun is going to kick up, there's a very bright flash, and it's very difficult to reacquire a target mid-shooting if you've lost it, so it is very important that you line up your first shot first. But if you get your first shot on, you'll probably be able to get the second one and kill them very quickly. And as for the overall recoil and handling and iron sights of this gun, in my personal experience, this feels very much so like an actual M1911. I've fired quite a lot of these guns, and the feel I get from World War II is very much so the feel I get from real life, albeit I'm kind of a novice at shooting. If I were an expert, I'd probably be more like John Wick, it'd be a little bit easier, but I feel that for most people that pick this gun up, the video game emulates that experience very, very well. Aim down sights time, sprint out, hipfire box size, all the handling attributes will be very good. I think this is true on all of the pistols. None of them have any slow or bad handling attributes, so it'll feel quite nice in those respects. One place it doesn't feel nice is magazine size. Historically accurate here, 7 rounds in the magazine. If you put extended mags in it, it goes up to 10, which I find strange about not just this weapon, but all of them. When you put in extended mags on pistols, the mags are like stupid extended, like 6 inches out of the gun, or like a cylindrical or drum barrel drum magazine or something like that, and you get like 2 extra bullets or 5 extra bullets or something, which I think was a model or scaling issue, but I do find it quite funny. Extended mags is one of the best attachments to run on this weapon. It's going to be one of your bread and butter ones because it increases your lethality overall. Reload time is the same as all the other pistols at 1.5 seconds, 1 second hustle, which is pretty quick. And I think that the best way to run this pistol is akimbo and insta-kill spamming people. That's just the smartest and best way to use the M1911. The M1911 is not traditionally what I would call a good gun. It has a lot of potential, but it is difficult to use and requires that you do not make any mistakes. Akimbo allows you to use it at its optimal potential with the most amount of forgiveness and the most amount of death, although it is a somewhat unique situation, and I really wouldn't be running it single. I have a very difficult time with it just running the single M1911. But we're not done on in-depth today. We're going to talk about the machine pistol as well. The machine pistol couldn't be much different in terms of damage. It'll deal 30 damage up close, 24 at its medium range, and then decrease down to 19 at a distance. So it's 4 to 6 shots to kill, basically like a submachine gun, and I'm going to say that quite a few times in this episode because the machine pistol is kind of like a bad pocket SMG. As of the most recent stats I had access to, headshot damage was 1x, so it deals no extra damage? Unsure. That may have been patched recently, that may have been fixed, but the last time I took a look at the code, it was 1x damage. Now you can run high caliber on this and make your headshots count, but otherwise they don't really count here. 4-shot kill range is 10.1 meters. It's a little bit better than you think, and I want to include that 10.1 because technically speaking, the M1911 is 8.9 and not 9, but these numbers are a little easier to remember. It just outperforms the M1911's 2-shot range by a meter, a little bit more than a meter, and the 4-shot kill range is better than you will experientially run into it. I had some problems with this gun, and when I use it as a solo weapon, it feels like people just eat bullets before they die, but if you slow down and test it and you hit all 4 shots perfectly, it's got a pretty decent 4-shot kill range that outperforms some of the other submachine guns in the game. And speaking of other submachine guns, rate of fire is 720 rounds per minute, which is kind of the same as most of the other submachine guns in this game. I think you can see where I'm going here. Time to kill is average in most respects, but the gun is very easy to use. It doesn't have an insane time to kill. It's a little better than the P08 and the SAP. It certainly doesn't compete with M1911 or some of the super fast killing guns or the WAF or anything, but it's average, it's workable, and the gun is just stupidly easy to use, which is by far its best attribute. The recoil, though, is fairly high, but it's mostly vertical, so if you line up your body on like hips or chest or whatever, you probably won't have a hard time controlling it. And the akimbo recoil is average. I did find one issue with this gun, unlike the other pistols, is that since it's fully auto, I get the movement penalty, so I find it harder to strafe when I'm going full auto, so you can't use left stick aiming very well. Akimbo's nice, I think that's probably my favorite way to use it, because I have a really hard time aiming down sights with this weapon. I don't know if it's the movement penalty, or the recoil, or the damage, but I feel like there are so many times when I am on target with my shots, and enemies just eat the bullets and waddle away, or sometimes I feel like my gun animation is on target and they just matrix around the bullets and I hit nobody. There's something subjectively about this weapon that makes me feel that it is worse than the statistics indicate. Perhaps it's just how I use it, but I did have a hard time using it as a solo weapon. Aim down sight, sprint out, hip fire box, all that stuff is great. You've seen this tile before because it's a pistol. All those things are going to be great. Magazine size is 10 by default, which is kind of poopy when you need 6 shots to kill, or 4 depending on your range. Extended mags will take this up to 15, and extended mags is your best friend on the machine pistol. There is no attachment that'll give you nearly the same utility as the extended mags. That's a whole new 5 rounds. That's another person you can kill. That's a lot more generous and consistent spraying. That's 2 people you could kill depending on the situations and what you're doing with the gun. It is very, very important that you be running extended mags and not any other attachments. Reload time's the same as M1911 and same as the other pistols, so nothing special there. And as for my overall rating on this weapon, I think it's interesting because personally, I feel that the machine pistol is a terrible solo weapon, but it's by far the best backup weapon. And that second reason is why I think most of the competitive players use it. The machine pistol is not great. If I just want to run the machine pistol and go around and try to kill people with the machine pistol, it's awful. The reserve ammo is very small. I run out very quickly. I have issues with being locked in place when firing full auto. The recoil is difficult at best. The damage is low. There's a lot of things about it that make it not fun to use as a solo weapon. I can do it akimbo. I will admit that akimbo is kind of fun. That's kind of easy. But a lot of guns, when you run akimbo, get easy just because when you sneak up at people, it's just like a shotgun. But as for a backup weapon, if I need to pull a pistol quickly and shoot somebody that's weak, that's only going to take one, maybe two shots to kill, I want one that shoots stupid fast. If I need a gun with a large magazine, if I want one that's fully automatic, if I panic and just swap guns and pull out my pistol and just spray all over in a whole bunch of smoke, odds are I can hit somebody and kill them with the machine pistol. Now, pros are going to use this for different because they kind of keep track of shots and where people are pushing from and what they're doing. But as an actual backup weapon that is designed to be simple to use and to pick off people that are weak, this one's the best. As a solo weapon to go hunting with, very, very rough, and I wouldn't recommend it. Guys, that is all for this episode of In Depth. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned something useful. If you did, don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. And this wraps up the guns for now. When they add DLC guns, I'll be doing new guns. But as of right now, I am completely donezo with guns In Depth. I may be reviewing perks and strategies and other things, myth-busting as I see fit. But we're hitting that time of the year where In Depth starts winding down, and I start playing around with other content. So I hope you enjoyed it. Drifter out. If you want all the weapon stats for World War II in your pocket to go, then look no further than the Ultimate Utility app by Brass Monkey. It's available on iOS and Android. There are links in the description, or you can just search for it in the App Store.